every now and then I start thinking about the Trinity and how irrational it is, how insane it is. The logical mind cannot understand the Trinity. And every Trinitarian has the belief that the next Trinitarian understands it, in that they're special, they're the ones that just don't understand it, and that's okay, because everyone else understands it. And every Trinitarian has that belief. They believe that the next guy understands it. So, well, this Trinitarian sitting next to me in this pew, he understands it, so, and I'm here believing in Trinity, so that's okay. And the fact is, he don't understand it, and the guy over here doesn't understand it, and the pastor behind the pulpit doesn't understand it. Nobody understands the doctrine of Trinity. It does not answer anything in the Scripture. There are a few things that it supposedly answers and helps you to understand. It would be God manifested in flesh, but that was a forgery. That is not true. That was changed in the Codex Alexandrius. It actually says who was manifested in flesh, and that's why the ASV and all the newer versions that have any credibility change it to who was manifested in flesh, because it doesn't really say God manifested in flesh. So if God didn't, the Bible doesn't say that God manifested in flesh, so the Trinity starts to not be necessary. And then you get 1 John 5 and 7, the Trinity supposedly answers that and explains it. But that was a forgery as well. It was added in the 10th century. It's not in the first 1,000 years of Christianity. It wasn't in any of their documents, in any of their first Johns. It was a forgery. It was added in the 10th century by the Roman Catholic Church. So what is it necessary for? What does it explain? Well, this is all they have left. After all the forgeries start to become exposed, Paul never said that the glorious appearing of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ. He said the appearing of the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ. And Jesus said he was going to come in the Father's glory. The great God is the Father. And once all of the forgeries in Peter 1, where they think that Peter called Jesus God, that's actually Lord. They changed it to God. That's a forgery as well. And when you start going through the forgeries, when you start going through all of the things that the Trinitarian Roman Catholic Church changed, and the Reformists in some instances after the Greek New Testament was formulated, they even back translated some Latin into the Greek as though it was original to the Greek, which it was not. They even added their garbage to it to try to make Jesus God, because they realized Jesus in the Greek is not God. They realized that, so they had to keep up these corruptions in their translations, and that's exactly what they did. So as we start to learn, as we start to see that these things are false, and you can go through my site, and you can look at every single video where I claim something's a forgery or mistranslation, and then you can take that to your pastor who's college educated. I'm not talking about a country preacher that doesn't know the Bible from a hole in his head. I'm talking about a college educated preacher. If you take any one of those videos to them, and you ask them if that's true, they will confess it to you. They will confess it to you. It is true. And then you need to have them explain why they still teach that verse the way they teach it. But they'll say, well, we believe it anyway. Okay. If it gets into the Bible, then it's God ordained. That's false. That's a lie. So do that. I adjure you. Do that. Do that. They will confess it to you if you ask them. But if you don't ask them, they're not going to tell you, because that's the big con of Christianity. So all these forgeries, they equal Jesus as God. And when you start to correct them, when you start to get rid of them, then there's no necessity for any Trinity. There's no way, there's no necessity to suggest that Jesus is the Most High God. None whatsoever. None whatsoever. And that's the reality. So it is not necessary. It does not help you understand the Scripture. And the doctrine itself makes no sense. It makes no sense in the beliefs that Trinitarians have. Now, in order for the Trinity to be true, now listen, each person, a spirit, has to be a person. Each person, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, have to be separate spirits. They're separate spirits because the Spirit is a person in the doctrine of the Trinity. It's a necessity. And you can go into various angles of the Trinity to where that is absolutely a necessity. Yet, God is a spirit, and that's a singular spirit. Now, when you're saying God, you're not talking about the persons of God. You're talking about the entire being of God. So if the entire being is a spirit, one singular spirit, not spirits, then it cannot be that three individual persons are three individual spirits. They have to be the same spirit, absolutely the same spirit. And a spirit is a person in the doctrine of the Trinity and in mainstream Christianity. Otherwise, the Holy Spirit cannot be deemed to be a person because it has no name. It has no name, it has no nothing. There's nothing that makes you think it's a person other than, oh, the Holy Spirit said. The Holy Spirit said. No, that's the Spirit of the Father. Now, I can show you clearly that the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of the Father, and the Spirit in the Bible, and the way that that word is used, means power, attributes, ability. The Spirit of wisdom, Spirit of knowledge, the Spirit of craftsmanship. All these things are just abilities, powers, and attributes. And Jesus went upon high. He received gifts, which are the gifts of the Holy Spirit, to give to men that God may dwell among them. God dwells among them because His Spirit, His power, and attributes imparted from Him are in them. It's really simple. But if you're going to say, as a mainstream Christian, that a spirit is a person, then you're going to say the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit are three individual persons that make up the same God, then you're going to need to explain how that one God is one spirit. How can that be? That makes no sense. It's illogical. Okay? The only thing that would really work there is the binitarian view, and to say that the Holy Spirit is the actual God, and that's the one spirit, and the Father and the Son share it. And that's why he probably said that he would come, him and the Father both would make their abode in you. And he didn't mention the Holy Spirit because the Holy Spirit is the God. So the binitarian argument is more logical than the Trinitarian argument, yet it's false in itself as well, because there's no pre-existent Jesus, easily demonstrated by the false presentations being refuted. But the doctrine of the Trinity makes absolutely no sense, and it is absolutely not necessary and absolutely does not answer anything in the Scripture. And if you think that there's anything in the Bible that I would need the doctrine of the Trinity or to believe that Jesus is God to answer, then try me, test me, come to me with it. Present something to me and say, look, you have to have the Trinity to understand this. Present something. You guys make that claim, that lie, that ridiculous claim, and you assume it's true because your pastors keep repeating it. Oh, the Bible cannot be understood without the Trinity. All right, test me. Bring something to me, anything, and say, Jeff, I want biblical and logical explanation of this without a Trinity. And watch me do it. I'll do it. And I'll do it easily, quickly, sharply, and you will not be able to answer. And that's the way it is. So if you think that you can do that, then do it. If not, then quit making the claim that the Bible cannot be understood without the Trinity, because that's an absolute lie. There's nothing in the Bible that can be understood with the Trinity. And what I'll do is, when you present something to say that the Bible cannot be understood, or this cannot be understood, this presentation, without believing or knowing or having the concept of a Trinity, I'm going to show you where the Trinity cannot work in that doctrine or that presentation. You watch. I'll do it. It's easy. It always comes back to bite you. It always does. God bless those that are His.